Welcome to the third part in our series on the remarkable body. This section is on storage systems and the excretory systems. Now first we're going to look at the three main storage organs in our body. We have the liver, the muscle, and the fat cells. And what I mean by storage systems is this is where when we take in excess food as nutrients, we store those nutrients so we can obtain them later, whether we need them for energy or for other functions. So let's go ahead and start with carbohydrates. And carbohydrates, when we think about carbohydrates, there are, of course, a lot of plant foods and fruits and vegetables, of course. But I use the example here of pasta because it is very starch-based, and when we think about storing our carbohydrates is generally when we consume too much starch. So if we think about the starch as the main energy form of carbohydrates because, and we'll talk about this next week, because we have starch and fiber, but fiber is not absorbed into our body. Only the starch and the sugars are. So when we consume carbohydrates, we start with the starch, and then this will be broken down into glucose. And we'll go through this in more detail next week. But that glucose is then stored in two different organs, both the liver and the muscle. And it's stored as glycogen. So glycogen is our body's storage form of carbohydrates. Starch is actually the plant storage form of carbohydrates. So we put this into both the liver, our liver, and our muscle. We do this so when we're not eating, we will have a supply of glucose. Now, if let's say you continue eating, you have a big pasta meal, and that starts with all the starch, it gets broken down into glucose, absorbed as glucose, and that's just a simple sugar in our bloodstream, and then it first fills up the liver and then the muscle. So the liver and muscle are now full. The next place this is going to go, if you continue to eat, is that will be converted into fat and stored in the fat cells. So again, it's your body's way of saying, okay, we have food, we have it in abundance, we are going to store it for later because we might need it later. And our bodies are really good at this because we had about 2.5 million years where we had food scarcity. It's only been the last couple hundred that we've actually had an abundance of food, in particular the last 30 to 40 years. So let's look at fat. Now, when you eat fat, it is broken down to fatty acids. And when it's brought into the body, it basically goes to the fat cells. These are also called adipose cells, and it gets stored there. And our fat cells are, we used to think of it more like a savings account, that we went and we just stored fat and just sat there. But people have described it more like a checking account, that we bring in the fat, we have too much of that fat, we don't need it for energy, it goes into those fat cells. But we're constantly storing that fat and then utilizing it for energy. So it's almost as if it's a checking account. So we're putting money in, taking money out. And same with fat. We're putting fat in, we're taking it out. So there's this constant synthesis of fat, making a fat, and then breaking down that fat to use for energy. Fat is an excellent source of energy. It's 9 calories for every gram. So it's our best, most dense source of energy. But if you don't need it to actually burn energy, then it will be stored as fat. Okay, so lastly, we'll take a look at protein. Protein is broken down into amino acids. These are, we call them the building blocks for life because they have so many functions in the body, which we'll get to in chapter 6. Amino acids are actually, and protein, are actually not stored. We don't have a storage form for protein. There is an amino acid pool. So the small pool of amino acids that the body can draw on, these amino acids, okay, I need to make, you know, the skin layer, or maybe I need to make the muscle, or, you know, I'm going to make the ligament, or I have an enzyme to make, or an antibody. It can pull from this little pool that's constantly being drawn from and we put into based on what we eat and what we need. But it's not a big storage pool is just small. So we really don't store protein to any extent. So when we need protein, we'll actually start breaking down our own tissues, such as our muscle tissues or some blood proteins, in order to obtain those amino acids. But protein, if you take in too much, let's say you eat too much protein, you don't need it for any functions, you've built everything you need to build as far as your structures and all the enzymes have been made, antibodies have been made, so you don't need that protein for any function. You don't need it for energy because you ate a big meal and now you're sitting on the couch and you're full. So what happens? We don't really have a storage place for it, so it gets converted into fat. It gets broken down and converted into fat and then stored in those fat cells. So kind of the moral of the story is that if you eat too much of carbohydrates, fat, or protein, they all eventually will end up in the fat cells as fat if you eat too much of them. Now let's take a look at the excretory system. And what we'll do is we'll start with the lungs. All metabolic processes in the body involve some waste products. So what I mean by that is that the cells will go through a metabolic process and then generate carbon dioxide. And in the last video, or the first video, we took a look at how the red blood cells delivers oxygen to the tissues and then it picks up the carbon dioxide. So that's a metabolic waste product. It delivers that essentially back to the lungs, and the lungs expire carbon dioxide, that CO2. So that's one of the ways the body rids itself of some of the waste products. And that's a normal metabolic process. Now the liver, I like you to think about it as the detoxifier of the body. So there are waste products, and it's from normal metabolic processes that we go through, our cells go through in the body. These waste products are in the blood, and the liver essentially pulls these out of the blood, and then it's going to dump them into the digestive tract. So that's going to be excreted through the feces. So that's another way that waste products are excreted. Lastly is the kidney. And I want you to think of the kidney as this big filtration system. And the blood will go through the kidney. It goes through this very complex filtration system, and the kidney will pull out what it wants and put back in what it wants. It needs more water, it needs more sodium, it needs, you know, more of this, or I'll put back in, and it actually filters out also some of those waste products. So these are the water-soluble waste products. Where that goes is into the urine. So that's going to concentrate in the bladder, be excreted through the urine. So it's a filter, and it's excreted through the urine. So these are the main excretory systems within the body. And that will end our section on the storage systems and excretory systems of the body.